Mike can tell you, going to say a few words, and then I'll have to tell you, I suppose, a bit more about how this exhibition came together. So my main task is to just say absolutely thank you for coming. I'm sure the people who haven't been before, what a beautiful venue. And what's even Carl likes to tell you these tales about how we came to be and not being not for profit and things. But from my point of view, I've hung exhibitions for probably the last 20 years. And there's ones that kind of hit you to your soul somehow. And I want to die because this makes me do this. But Mike's has, somehow, I think it's a connection with nature and people. So I would imagine most people in this room know Mike miles less than I do. Probably you've had the privilege of being his student and his daughter and knowing him all your life. But there's something when you meet him, you connect to him, that kind of brings this emotion out in you. So it's a privilege to get to know him. I've only met him twice before today, but I'm in love with him. I think it takes a man like that to produce art like this somehow. And I think his name will go on for years and years. For us, this would be shown, in the greatest spaces, in Paris, in Rome, in Venice. But I think for us, it's just like, how do we bring such great artists so that we can show it to the people of Rosendale and Lancashire, because they deserve to see it as much as Rome or Venice or wherever else it should be. So for us, it's about showing great art that actually you can see at your doorstep. And if we get a reputation for doing that, people will keep coming. So thank you for coming. I'm not going to say much more, but okay. I'll introduce you to Terry next, I think.
Okay. Well, it's been my pleasure actually to be part of the organisation of this show of mine. It's absolutely brilliant stuff. You don't see this very often in any kind of normal commercial gallery. This may be museum stuff, but the quality of some of this stuff is amazing. Anyway, welcome to the Whittaker. And Mike knows his dancing tree. This was purchased by myself and my wife many years ago. Dancing tree being the big one as you walk in at the very end. Jackie, I think it's a great event. I really do. I wish you one in the future. And I think all the volunteers who hung the paintings, I was here a couple of days ago, just about 7 or 8 people hanging paintings. Absolutely amazing. So that was really great to see. A special thanks to Jackie and Julian, who they've been to Anderson a few times, and they've been to our house, etc., and offices, where all this became together as one. The exhibition actually started with a chance meeting of Ella Cole and Bob Frith. Now, they're directors of the Dave Pearson Trust. Now, Ella is also a part-time curator for the Whittaker. So that's the tenuous connection. Now, once Ella came round to my area and saw Mike Knowles' stuff, she was just blown away. And she just asked, if there's any chance in the future of putting a show together, then the Whittaker would be the place to be. She's part-time curator for the Whittaker, and she does the Dave Pearson Trust as well. So I don't think Ella's here, is she? No? No, this is relevant. Anyway, so that's how it came about. So, as we say, the show lasts for 7 weeks. We're really, really proud of this absolute terrific show. And don't forget, there's one in the hallway, the Muses. The Muses have never been seen before in the UK. They're from Hong Kong. Mike did a series of paintings and drawings, the Muses. And there's 9 or 10 of them out there. They've all got drawings as well, but there was just no space to put the drawings. So, sorry about that, but they're the paintings. As I say, they've never been seen before in the UK. So, it's a bit of a one-off, and it's and one for the Whittaker as well, really. So there's not much more I can say, really, except me and Mike get on really well. We're good pals, and we often spend a few drinks and a few chats together, and his family as well. So it's a pleasure for me to do what we've achieved, and I must say, it's been brilliant for me. It's the first time I've done it, so I'm really proud about that as well.
Thank you very much.
It's a bit embarrassing because this is usually the point at which I nip outside for a smoke. There's not much more I can say, really. I think this is an exhibition that initially I entered into very reluctantly. I didn't know the Whittaker. I'd reached an age where I'd had experience of putting one person's shows together, which took a lot out of oneself and left you feeling a bit empty afterwards. This has been remarkably different, thanks to the efforts of Terry here, and in particular of Jackie and Julian and their staff, who've been absolutely marvellous to work with. And it's been so painless, it's unbelievable. Somebody asked me, or said to me coming in, said, I hope the exhibition is going to be a success. And I said, well, in this context, I don't know how you measure success, but this is it. So many people that I know, recognise, old friends, people I've not seen for years, some people I've seen more recently. But to meet you all, that you've all taken the trouble to come here to see the work, I'm quite moved by that. It's a lovely feeling, and that's a success, I think. The other thing is that I shook hands with somebody about 10 minutes ago who's a scientist, and Jackie raised the subject of the paintings and what they're about. Well, I've gone most of my life without people showing any interest in what they're about. They've often been interested in what kind of painting they are, but what they're about didn't occur to them. The scientists I spoke to, and I said, well, it's 40 years since I heard an artist of any standing use the term nature, but scientists use it all the time. So, to an extent, that's been an obsession with me. Looking at the world around me, and trying to make some kind of sense about it, some kind of visual sense, because art and science are about the same kind of exploration. You know, what is this all about? What are we doing here? How are we coping with it? What's going to happen to it? So, to have had the privilege of spending a lifetime chucking some paint around and thinking about things like that, that's been marvellous. And then to have an occasion like this just caps it. So thank you very much to everybody. Thank you so much to the Whittaker, which is a wonderful establishment. Why I never didn't know about it, I don't know, except I never venture off Anglesey. Thanks to all of you. Thanks in particular to Terry, who's put all this effort into it to make this wonderful catalogue. And it's good to see another significant friend of mine, Dave Gunning, who is amazing for gallery in Topperton. Dave is responsible for reintroducing my work to this part of the world. I've been shoved out of Lancashire, first of all by the government that changed Warrington into Cheshire. Which I took exception to. And then secondly by hiding myself away in Anglesey for many years. So it's good to come back here. The last occasion I came was a very sad one. It was the funeral of a lovely artist called Tom Sissons. And old friends got together for that one as well. Thank you very much for coming. It's been lovely.
Thank you.